topic is single minute exchange of dyes. This term was coined by Shigeo Shingo.
This is a guy.
So this guy changed the whole industry. He changed the whole game. Before that, the setup time was seen as necessary time, but he said it is not the value adding time. And this is a very, very famous book of him. A very good book. I would definitely recommend if you really want to go into detail of this topic and seriously reduce your setup time. Single minute exchange of die. So it doesn't matter if your setup time is 4 hours or 2 hours, 20 minutes. The aim of this method is to achieve the setup time in less than 10 minutes. So 9 minutes or the less, so that we achieve this in single digit. That's the name of this tool, single minute exchange of dies. In this series of setup time, we will be first seeing how we can use this method, what are the different steps. So we will be seeing this the lean tool in 6 steps. And after that, we will see the examples. First example would be how to implement, how to use SMED for reducing preventive maintenance time. And the second example would be how we can reduce the setup time on any normal semi-automatic or automatic machine. So let's go ahead. So single minute exchange of dies, as the name suggests, we are aiming to reduce our setup time to 9 minutes or less than 9 minutes. There are 6 main steps to do it. Very easy to follow, very simple. The step number one is to divide the whole setup time into 2 main categories. The first category is internal activities, second category is the external activities. All the activities which are done in the machine or we have to stop the machine in order to perform them are internal activities. And all the activities which we are performing when the machine is stopped but are outside the machine, we are filling the job order number on in the batch book, we are entering the data in ERP system, we are counting the parts, we are transporting the parts, everything else is considered to be the external activity. So once we have categorized all the setup activities into these 2 categories, the next step is, step number 2 is to externalize all the external activities. For example, we are doing the entry in the ERP system. For that, we don't need a machine. So why we should do the entries in the ERP system in the computer when the machine is being stopped? So we externalize it. So we do these entries when the machine is running with the next job order, for example. So step number 2 was to externalize all the activities either before the machine is being stopped and when the previous job order is running, or after the next job order has already been started on the machine after the setup. So through this, now the setup time is only comprised of internal activities. The next step would be step number 3 in SMED will be to externalize the internal activities. So it could be that during that machine setup time, we are replacing the bits of a milling cutter in the machine. So it is actually internal activity. And we are changing the bits and we are aligning the bits and doing all these things. But if we would have a spare head of milling chuck, in which when the machine is running with the previous job order, we are already setting up this new chuck or second chuck, and we are aligning all the bits and we are replacing all the bits, and as soon as the machine is stopped after finishing the previous job order, we are just replacing the whole milling head. So with that, we have externalized this inspection of the worn out bits and aligning them, screwing them and tightening them, everything we have externalized. So this is the aim of step number 3. Step number 4 is to focus on remaining internal activities. Now we have relatively shorter setup time, but we are aiming here to perform these internal activities as quicker as possible. So what we are doing here, maybe we have 5 screws to tighten. Maybe we need only 2 screws. So we do this design change. Maybe we don't need the screws at all. We are now in the current state. We are having few screws, and with the improvement in this step number 4, we will use the levers. So we need not to unscrew or screw or do anything, any activity like this. So we would easily save a lot of time. So this step involves making the internal activities as quicker as possible. The step number 5 is not about reducing the setup time itself, but it is about optimizing the external activities. For example, now the setup time has been reduced from 20 minutes to 10 minutes, for example, but now the worker is doing the external activities. It is taking him longer time, or it's taking him 10 minutes. And the whole aim of this step is to make the external activities quicker, so that we can use the operator for running the machine, more important value adding activities, and not doing the setup time. So this could be if the operator was changing the bits and manually adjusting and aligning. If he would have a gauge or something, he could do the alignment and tightening of these bits on the chuck instead of 10 minutes, maybe in 2 minutes or 3 minutes. So this step aims to reduce the external activities, the effort for the external activity. The step number 6 is to eliminate the setup time completely. How this is possible, that we eliminate a setup time completely? This requires design change. It could be that we have 2 customers and we are delivering 2 identical parts with a very little change. It could be a change in color, it could be one part has 2 holes, another part has 1 hole, or a very small design change. One part has 2 small inexpensive parts, and other customer is asking for only 1 small part on a big assembly. And we are, for example, we are delivering these products which our customer further is assembling into a big assembly. So it means it will not affect the appearance for the end customer. In that case, we can talk to our customers and ask them if it will make any difference, if we will modify their product a little bit. For example, we will deliver the same part with 2 holes to both the customers. Or for 1 customer, it doesn't matter if the color is brown or it is black. In my practical experience, we were delivering 2 assemblies there, and the difference was, to 1 customer, we are delivering with 2 components, and another customer, we are delivering with only 1 component. So we asked the customer who was receiving with 1 component if his functionality will be affected if we deliver with that 2 small components. And after discussion, we knew that for him it doesn't matter. So for us, we just had 1 standardized process for 1 assembly with these 2 small inexpensive parts, which in the end, the increase of cost was just few cents, but it saved a lot of management effort, a lot of effort to maintain different articles, different inventory, and we could reduce a lot of buffer area for implementation of our Kanban system. So all these benefits. So these were the main 6 steps which you could use to reduce any setup time, and not only the setup time, but also for optimizing and reducing the downtime in many other categories. As previously mentioned, preventive maintenance, it could be R&D trial time, it could be the planned weekly cleaning. These are all the categories you could optimize easily with these 6 steps.